Today, I want to share how the top 1% of Etsy print-on-demand sellers find their niches that they want to design in. If you do not know me yet, my name is Christina. I am a full-time print-on-demand seller. And if you do know me, you might be wondering what's going on with my background. I have now picked up my life and started traveling while working. So I'm going to be setting up makeshift studios pretty much everywhere I go. And you'll see I've got a nice shine of sweat all over me. I am currently in Bali and it is hot. Almost every single new seller that I see get set up on Etsy with print on demand has three different niches: the nurse niche, the teacher niche, and usually like a positivity niche. Unfortunately, these are top of mind for every single seller, and that means they are super saturated. So especially as a new seller, trying to sell within these niches is going to be impossible. You're not gonna be able to compete with the other stores that are already ranking on page one and have thousands of reviews and sales behind them. So with so much competition now on Etsy, we really need to do our research before we start designing in niches so that we know we actually have a chance to be found in those niches so that we can make sales, especially as new sellers. And the best way to do that that I have found is using eRank. And I do want to let you know ahead of time that eRank and every single Etsy research platform is not actual Etsy data. It is based on what data Etsy does give out because they don't share all of their information and they use algorithms to create educated guesses on sales and search volume and competition. So nothing is 100% accurate when you're actually using these tools, but they are still a fantastic guideline to try to figure out what you want to sell. So let's go into eRank and I'm going to show you exactly what tools I use in eRank to find niches and how you can use it too to start creating designs in niches that you actually have a chance in. So the first way that I like to use eRank is to find what I call sub-niches. So we talked about nursing shirts and teaching t-shirts, but those are so vague and oversaturated now. So I like to find sub-niches. So say we did want to create a nurse sweatshirt. I'm gonna type in nurse sweatshirt and eRank is gonna give us some stats back on exactly how many people are using that keyword. So you can see it gets a really good amount of searches per month, almost 5,500, but the competition is crazy. I avoid everything that has this competition in red. But what is super helpful is if you just scroll down, you're going to find sub niches within the nurse sweatshirt niche that have a lot less competition, but are still highly searched. So right here, NICU, NICU, I don't know how to say it, I'm not a nurse. NICU nurse sweatshirt has a lot less competition, but it's still searched pretty often. We have labor and delivery nurse sweatshirt, still a decent amount of searches, way less competition. And you can just keep scrolling down here and find ones that have a good ratio of searches to competition. I find this super helpful if I ever want to do things like holidays. Holidays are super oversaturated, especially like Christmas. So if you did want to design for holidays, this is a great way to find sub niches within Christmas or any of the other holidays that you have a better chance of ranking for. Another way to come up with niches, say you don't even know what niche you want to design for, you can look up what your competitors are using for tags to see if maybe those are tags that you want to be using in your keywords. So first on Etsy, you would actually look for one of your competitors or someone that maybe you want to see what they are using. Maybe they're kind of designing in the same niches that you are, or you just want some ideas. Go and grab their handle of their shop. And then in eRank, come over to competition and we're going to go to your competition and tags. Once you actually are in here, you're going to paste in the Etsy shop name of whose tags you want to see. I grabbed one for myself and I'm going to hit analyze shop listings. And then once we're in here, we're going to see every single tag that this shop has ever used. And what I like to do is I like to sort by competition the lowest. You may have to click that sort button twice, but once you do have that, you're gonna see we're going to start seeing what keywords they have that have low competition, but they might also have low searches. But what we wanna do is start scrolling down and find the ones that actually do have searches. So we have Silly Goose Sweater. it's not too many searches, but literally like no competition. So we could write this one down. It's still quite a little bit low. It still says less than 20. So that could literally mean one. We're not sure, but maybe I would just write it down and keep note, but we're going to keep scrolling. We have here whale sweater. Right here, book travert shirt. This one seems pretty good. A decent amount of searches. I like to do anything ideally between 50 to 100 plus, and then only with max a few thousand competition. So a book travert shirt is something I would write down. We have right here, RD8 shirt. I don't know what that means. We'll have to do some researching. Maybe you know what that means. We have a strawberry sweater. Here is a perfect example of what I'm talking about. Strawberry sweater. Look at the amount of searches and the amount of competition. That is a fantastic ratio. We have this here, Monument Valley. Whale sweatshirt. It's a good day. These ones are a little bit low. Here's another great one. Just silly goose. Skeleton peace sign. We have dental hygiene shirt. So what I like to do is grab a few of your competitors. And when you are doing research, and if you are an Etsy seller, you should be doing your competitor research, is I would get a notepad, go through a bunch of your competitors, and start noting down the keywords within the niches that you could design for. So strawberry sweatshirt. Maybe I also put a strawberry shirt, a strawberry tank top, strawberry hoodie. Maybe always be using that strawberry sweatshirt tag, especially if you're doing the sweatshirt or if you're doing a hoodie. I did forget to mention earlier that I do use the paid version of eRank, because otherwise you're not going to be able to see the competition. And there's quite a few different tools within eRank that you're not going to be able to use. And unfortunately, they kind of are some of the most important ones. You'll be able to see searches, which is super helpful, but not the competition, which without the competition, you're not going to get the ratios. So I would recommend, at least if you're just starting out on Etsy, download eRank and get the paid version for about a month and do as much competitor research as you can. And then perhaps you can cancel it if you don't want to keep paying for it. But I find the value in keeping it. So I actually do pay consistently for the monthly subscription, and I have for over a year now. But another tool that I like to use is to see current trends. So you can take a look at TrendBuzz and monthly trends. So using TrendBuzz, you can see the most searched keywords within the last 30 days. So let's start scrolling down and see if there's any that we could apply. T-shirt, those are always kind of up. We can see that Valentine's Day is starting to be searched. We have hoodies and sweatshirts being searched. Valentine's gifts, if you are doing anything like digital downloads, maybe calendars or planners, those are currently trending, especially because it is the beginning of the year. We have embroidery, bridesmaids gifts, planner. We have, what's some other ones we could do? Some wall decor, digital print. If you want to do groomsmen's gifts, this is a great way just to see the minds of the current Etsy shoppers. Then the last way that I love to use eRank is to understand when I need to start designing for holidays, if I am choosing to design for a certain holiday that year. So St. Patrick's Day is coming up. So on eRank, I would just look up St. Patrick's Day. So once St. Patrick's Day comes up, you're going to see the regular stats. Again, this is where you can go to find sub niches, but a great way for holidays is to see exactly when people start searching. You don't want to be designing for St. Patrick's Day in March. People have already shopped, but you maybe don't think about St. Patrick's Day until it's very, very close. This happens to me all the time when I'm not keeping track. Like, I did want to create a few Valentine's Day designs this year, but I don't know why I completely blanked on Valentine's Day until February hit, and it is way too late for me to even bother adding designs because they're not going to arrive in time, and I missed the trend upward, so I'm probably not going to be ranking high. St. Patrick's Day is starting to get searches all the way in November, and it's still going up in December. January, we're at over 13,000 searches for St. Patrick's Day products, and then we hit a major trend here. This was still January. February is when we're at our peak, and then things start dying down a little bit in March for these last minute shoppers. So based on this, you might want to start designing for St. Patrick's Day all the way back in November. But we wouldn't know that without seeing this trend report from eRank. So it might be helpful for you if you did want to go for holidays. If you follow me for a while, you can see why I'm not huge on holidays if you are just starting out. But if you do feel like you really want to design for some holidays, I would use eRank and start making a calendar, especially if you're going to do what I said earlier and only buy it for like a month or two. Take note, write down every single holiday that you think you're going to want to design for and start writing the dates and add them to a calendar of when you need to be getting your designs up so that you catch the uptrend and you want to be as early in the uptrend as possible so that you can start ranking higher and gaining some momentum before the major sales month for that holiday. I hope this was helpful, guys. This is just how I use eRank. There actually might be some tools that I don't even know about. And if you do use eRank in a different way, I would love to hear how in the comments below. And if you learned anything new, I would love to hear that too. And if you are not yet, please subscribe. And if you haven't yet, like this video. It would help me so much in being able to make more videos like this for you and for me to understand what is helpful for you guys. All right, thanks, and I'll see you next week.